Hi, and welcome to SnapGene's video library about molecular cloning. In this video, we are going to review the key concepts of what is a molecular clone and what is a cloning vector. But first, some background. The last 50 or so years have brought great advances in molecular biology, engineering, and medicine. But each and every tool started in nature. Much like domestic dogs are derived from wolves with direct influence from humans, each of the tools in the molecular biology toolbox started as a natural phenomenon. Scientists study these phenomena and learn how to modify them to make robust laboratory tools. In essence, scientists domesticated them. As we talk about various techniques in upcoming videos, we will learn that there are shortcomings and challenges associated with different techniques. These shortcomings were the incentive to improve and expand this molecular toolbox. We are going to start by defining a molecular clone. Molecular cloning refers to the capture of a unique nucleic acid fragment in such a way that it can be grown and propagated away from the genome it originated from. In order for a DNA fragment to be propagated, it must be transferred to a DNA vector. In this image, we can see in yellow a DNA cloning vector or plasmid. We can also see the schematic representation of a chromosome. To make a molecular clone, a small fragment of interest in red is isolated from the eukaryotic genome and introduced into the DNA vector. Once recombined, the recombinant molecule, which includes the fragment of interest plus the vector, is then transferred into a bacterial host. Let's take a look at a DNA vector to see how this happens. The most common type of DNA vector is a bacterial plasmid. A DNA plasmid is a small circular piece of DNA that grows in bacteria independent from the bacterial chromosome. One of the most well-known plasmids is PBR322. Here is an image of the plasmid PBR322 as you might see it in SnapGene. Notice the name of the plasmid is indicated in the center along with its length. Several restriction enzyme sites are indicated along the perimeter of the plasmid. Now let's simplify what we are looking at and take a closer look at this plasmid. I want to draw your attention to the key features that make this plasmid a functional cloning vector. The first is the yellow feature labeled ORI. This is the E. coli origin of replication. This element allows the plasmid to be replicated by E. coli's DNA replication machinery, independently from the bacterial genome. Next, shown in green, are two different antibiotic resistance genes, ampicillin and tetracycline, each with its associated promoter. Expression of the proteins encoded by either of these genes protect bacteria, which contain this plasmid. Normal bacteria, when exposed to ampicillin or tetracycline, die. If the bacteria contain intact PBR322, they will survive. Selectable markers are found on all plasmids. Numerous functional elements have been added to plasmids over the years. One of the most important features to be added is the multi-cloning site. In this example, plasmid PUC19, we see our first look at a multi-cloning site. First, note that there are some enzyme sites indicated in the ampicillin resistance gene, as well as in the ORI replication origin. The multi-cloning site, sometimes abbreviated as MCS, is over here at 3 o'clock. It is a cluster of restriction enzyme sites that we will use when cloning into this plasmid. Multi-cloning sites make cloning much easier. They create more flexibility in how DNA fragments can be inserted into a plasmid without destroying the essential elements the plasmid needs to function. SnapGene allows you to select enzymes based on how often they are detected in your sequence. If an enzyme is only present once, the text for it is seen in bold. Therefore, all of the enzymes displayed on this plasmid currently are only present once in this plasmid sequence. In upcoming videos, we will review the use of the enzyme selector tool and how important the use of unique enzyme sites is for successful cloning. This image shows the most common model organisms used in research. While each organism poses its own unique biological questions, each one is also a model for some aspect of human biology. Each organism requires dedicated vectors. They will differ from bacterial plasmids because they will contain features that allow their replication and gene expression in the given model organism, whether that is mice, yeast, fruit flies, or other. Numerous sources exist on the internet which list the various DNA vectors and the specific features which make them functional. These features include organism-specific origins of replication, promoters, and selectable markers. The sequences of many commonly used vectors are available directly from SnapGene's website. To summarize, a molecular clone consists of a DNA fragment of interest that has been introduced into a DNA vector. The vector allows the fragment of interest to be propagated in a host organism. Because we are frequently mixing genetic material from different organisms, such a molecular clone is often referred to as a recombinant DNA molecule. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.